Hello and welcome to the intermission program of our nice Mozart concert today at the Turku Concert Hall. And this, we have here Julian Rachlin, and this interview is recorded the previous day, and we just heard the dress rehearsals of the nice concert. And it's a concert full of Mozart. So, what gave you the incentive to play and conduct Mozart? Does Mozart have do you have like a personal relationship with Mozart? And
yes, we are great friends, and we spend a lot of time together. Yeah. No, I mean it's not a Mozart year, but it doesn't mean that Mozart must rest. He's one of my maybe together with Bach my favorite composer. Yeah. Although that is also a sin to say, what about all the other great geniuses? So, I grew up in Vienna. Vienna has been my home since I'm 3 years old. So for the last 37 years, now everybody knows my age. So, and of course, growing up in Vienna, you automatically get a very strong sense of, you know, Mozart and his... the streets he was walking in, the houses he was living in, the pieces that he was composing, he composed so much in Vienna, and of course the amazing musical tradition that Vienna has, the city of Vienna being one of the great epicenters of classical music. And so I think there is reason enough to come with a clean, with a pure Mozart program this time, with two symphonies, with a Figaro overture, and with the A major, most popular maybe, Violin Concerto. So this is a very popular program, and I hear that the concert is sold out, so yes, that is a good sign. But that doesn't mean that I only play Mozart. Of course, my repertoire is much more expanded than just one composer, of course, but I'm having a beautiful time with the orchestra. It's a wonderful orchestra, it's a wonderful concert hall, and I enjoy Turku very much. It's my first visit here, and so it's really a very nice collaboration for me with the orchestra, and I hope to be back.
Yeah, we really appreciate your visit here, and so this is your first time in Turku, and have you had any time to visit the city or see the sights? Or
I didn't really go sightseeing, yeah. But you know, I like to walk around the city and just feeling the energy of the city, and you have a great food scene.
Well, yeah,
I noticed. So you have lots of wonderful restaurants, especially by the. How do you say, by the water?
Yeah, by the Aura River. Riverside.
By the Aura River, yes. Yeah. I love strolling around there and checking out the nice places in between the rehearsals. And yeah. And especially today, it's a fabulously beautiful day, so I can't wait to go and have a walk.
Yeah, sounds nice. So you're doing like a double... you have a double responsibility in this concert. You're conducting as well as playing the solo parts of the concerto. So, do you really like enjoy the challenge of doing two things at once?
I really don't care if I play violin or if I wave my hands in the air or if I play viola. It doesn't matter. The most important is to, in a way, it's the musical message that comes across. The musical message between, you know, myself and the orchestra, and yes, of course, most of the I grew up playing the violin, and since I'm 3 years old, I'm playing violin. But I never looked at myself as a violinist. I know maybe it sounds strange for the people, because of course, 70% of my work is on the violin still. It's still the main object, but. I am focusing more and more on the conducting, and conducting also big symphonies. I'm being very careful with the repertoire because I want to keep playing violin, and I do a lot of viola as well. I also teach at the university, at the private university in Vienna, so there is a lot of things that interest me, but I am not focused that, you know, violin or viola or teaching, it's all music, and it's all what I try to share my musical ideas, either with the students or with the great conductors that I'm lucky to work with as a soloist. Yeah. I get to learn from the great maestros of today, and also with the young, upcoming conductors. And so it's a never-ending journey. You always try to learn and try to be curious, because that is what keeps me fresh. That is what keeps me being in love with music.
Yeah, that's true. And you're really like you have a vast command of the musical area. So you're like a super multi-talent. So yeah. So you've been around the world in fabulous places and met fabulous conductors and seen wonderful people. And what is your best favorite place to perform? You've been in Carnegie Hall and all around the world. So
it's a very difficult question. It's like asking what is my favorite composer. So, but you know, I love going everywhere, more or less. I don't have places that I don't like to go, because I love to find out about the different cultures. I like to feel the different mannerisms, the different traditions, the different ways of humor, the different way of expressivity of each country, of each culture. This is one of the most wonderful things about my profession, is that for me, there is only one country, I always say, and this is this country. It's called planet Earth.
Yeah.
So I am everywhere a stranger, but I everywhere also feel a little bit at home. So it's a very strange lifestyle, but yes. For me, it's the most beautiful lifestyle that I could imagine. So. Of course, Carnegie Hall is fantastic, and Musikverein in Vienna is fantastic, and Konzertgebouw is amazing, but there are so many great halls, and it's not only about the halls, it's about the people. Mm. It's about the musicians that I work with, and it's about the people who we perform for. So it's so many factors that make a visit, you know, wonderful, and that you will remember. And I try to take the nice memories from every visit. So I'm not going to say one favorite place.
Yeah,
I have many favorite places.
Yeah, marvelous. And thank you for this interview and for your time.
It's my pleasure.
And we'll continue the concert with Mozart Symphony number 20. Was it 29?
29.
Yes, A major. And the Haffner Symphony 35.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.